demonstration is all about, and what is it that you...
How are you doing, my friend?
We are trying to get people to vote by mail if they are eligible. Now, in Texas, you're eligible if you're over 65 years old, if you're disabled, if you're in jail but not convicted, and if you're not going to be in your home area during the election period. Voting by mail is far superior to waiting for election day, because it might rain, or your car might break down. And if you vote by mail, you're much more likely to vote. Now, tomorrow is the first day, the 30th is the first day in which you can file an application to vote by mail. I've got some applications with me.
Right. What about the recent issues with the program voting by mail that have been raised in some of the races in Dallas County?
It gets raised just about every time, but I don't know if anybody ever got in trouble for it. It does come up quite often, voting by mail. But that has to do with vote harvesters.
Yeah.
We're not vote harvesters. We're just encouraging people to use this way of increasing their voting strength.
Okay.
Furthermore, Attorney General Abbott is still trying to get the voter ID bill in effect, even though the government has stopped him temporarily, the federal government has. He's filing in the courts. So the voter ID bill does not affect vote by mail. So vote by mail is a way around the bad parts of the voter ID bill.
Right. So you're saying that people who are eligible should take advantage of this voting by mail feature, but would you also tell them to beware of vote harvesters, and what are the signs to watch out for?
All I know about that is that you're supposed to mail the thing yourself.
Yes.
You're supposed to sign it and mail it yourself. And if somebody helps you, they have to sign it too.
I'm a registrar. Let me explain that this vote by mail. What it is, okay, the difference between a harvester will not be certified by the county.
Okay.
The county issues all these registrars, which I don't have mine with me, but they issue them a white registration card that shows them with their signatures, which is stamped by the county clerk, to show that this person is a bona fide registrar, that they've taken the training through the county elections department. Those are the people that can actually come out and register you. And normally it's a big ballot. They register it and you sign it. But if you're unable to sign it, a witness can sign that you were the person that gave the information. And then it's signed and then it is mailed into the elections. That's how that works. So what they have to look for is make sure that they have their certification card stamped by Dallas County Elections Department, then that they are bona fide. Other than that, that would be considered a harvester.
Okay, gotcha. Very well. Okay. So overall, your message today is a positive one. Take advantage of this.
Take advantage of early voting and vote by mail, and register and vote. The democracy is under attack in this country right now. Not only voting rights, but just the right to peaceable assembly, the right to stand here, the right to hand out leaflets. Everything else is under attack in this country. So if you want to stand up for democracy, you need to fight back. And that would include voter registration. Our brothers from the Amalgamated Transit Union, for example, who are here and is willing to be interviewed in English or Spanish, knows quite a bit about voter registration, and they are hoping to get especially people who ride the transit system to register and vote this year. Is that right?
That's correct.
What is your name, sir?
My name is Gene Lance. My name's on the leaflet. And my contact information is all there. Okay? Doesn't say Gene Lance,
does
it? Yeah, well, I'm sorry.
Made a message. All I had my name on there. Get registered, vote.
Yeah.
This is my thing, and I tell everybody as I go through and educate them.
Thank you, brother.
Thank you.
There's a lot of things wrong, but you gotta find a solution. It's okay to have the complaints, but have a solution. How do you bring about the solution? You vote in people that are like-minded individuals. That's how you change the system, through the power to vote. And throughout the years, the power of the vote has been diminished so much, okay? And people are basically, it's an attack on voters now. And they
Absolutely.
Really have to be savvy to look at what's really happening. Just look around our state. Our state right now is the laughingstock of America. Let's be real, that's what's happening right now, okay? So we gotta bring our state back to predominance again, in everything, voting, supporting all people from all walks of life. If you notice, everything is about middle class and the one percenters. Have they not forgot there's a poor class of people? They haven't even not forgotten that there's homeless people, and none of these issues are ever addressed when they're having these conversations. It's always middle class and one percenters. It's time that we include everybody. And one part of my platform is, it's enough of America for everybody to be successful. Okay? We that has the, I ain't gonna say me, because I'm not included, I'm not rich. Let's get that straight. But the people that are rich, if they were just to give up a little bit, you know, so to make the pool bigger, everybody can benefit from that. So, like I said, with these gentlemen, why I'm out here supporting them is because they belong to an organization I belong to. Second of all, I'm a peace officer, so that public retirement system would affect me if they changed the retirement system, the TRS, the Texas Retirement System, and take it to a 401k, which is very risky. Like I said, some of these gentlemen don't get Social Security because they live off their pensions. So if you put in a 401k, stock market drops, guess what? They're now forced to go on welfare and Medicaid and the whole nine yards. So that's what I believe. And this gentleman here, I like that. I like that. He's working off 8.5 years. So, yeah.
Rolando Rodriguez.
Español, inglés.
Como
okay. Me habla de la iniciativa para registrar a personas en el sistema que pasen por la calle o por el tránsito. ¿Qué es eso?
Este sistema que tenemos aquí, estamos preguntándole a la gente que se registren para votar. Que se registren para votar. Antes de las elecciones se registran para con tiempo se registren, y porque su voto es su voz.
¿Todavía tiene la gente tiempo para registrarse para la elección del 29 de mayo o estamos hablando ya de la de
para empieza el 30 de mañana? Ajá. Tiene que registrarse para
mañana. Es la última.
Mañana empieza. Am I correct?
Right, tomorrow starts.
Mañana empieza, o sea, el 30, which is the 30th, up to time to register?
Yeah. It's actually, if you register now, I believe it opens the 30th, and it should end about the 21st of May.
Yeah.
That's right,
about
the 21st of May.
Es cuando ya paran las registraciones.
Sí. Claro, ya ha habido controversia últimamente por votar por correo. Ya ve el juicio que le tienen ahorita el señor Pedrán. ¿Qué le recomendaría usted a la gente cuando alguien viene a decirle que le ayuda a registrarse por correo? ¿Que nada más vaya con personas certificadas como ustedes?
Yo no soy certificado. Yo nomás vengo a ayudar, a asistir, a pasar la voz o la palabra, pues, diciéndoles, hey, miren, pónganse en alertos, porque ahorita la democracia está bajo de un ataque. Por ejemplo, si la ley que quisieron pasar de los votantes que tengan identificación, okay, que requieren que usen identificación, bueno, eso le va a afectar mucha gente, a los afroamericanos, le va a afectar a los latinoamericanos y los que son de menores. Y cuando uno le quita el poder de votar, le quita la voz a uno. Y lo que nosotros queremos pasar la información a toda la gente, igual, no le hace que sean que sea. Pero a decirles, miren, es importante de ir a registrarse a votar, porque su voto es su voz. Y si ustedes no se quieren a estar nomás calmados, viendo lo que pasa y eso, este estado va a cambiar más y se va a empeorar para la gente de menores.
Sí. Y el voto por correo le facilita el voto a los ancianos, a los discapacitados. ¿Me puede hablar de eso?
Sí, señor. Sí, por ejemplo, si uno está incapacitado o sea anciano, y es muy difícil para ellos para manejar, a tomar el tránsito público, es muy difícil para un anciano para hacer eso, solo que registrándose para hacerlo de la casa, o sea, nomás usa su voto, de votar en la casa. La boleta le llega a su casa en tiempo para que si uno quiere, bueno, vamos a ver este candidato que tiene que decir y esto, puede tomar la información de cada candidato o cada proposiciones que hay por las ciudades. Eso es muy importante para darles tiempo para ver, bueno, vamos a investigar qué tiene esa proposición. Esa proposición, ¿qué va a ser para mí? ¿Qué va a ser para mi familia? Y bueno, y ya entonces ya estamos más alerto, y especial también los alumnos que están en las escuelas, están en colegios y tienen diferente horario de uno, que no podrá tener tiempo de ir a votar. Solo que ellos les ayuda también, porque nomás les mandan la boleta temprano, se registran, mandan la boleta temprano y luego ya nomás votan y
¿Usted se le recomendaría a nuestros ancianos latinos que aprovechen lo del voto por correo?
Oh, absolutamente que sí, es lo que le recomiendo a los ancianos, a la gente que no puede salir
discapacitados
y a los alumnos, les recomiendo
mucho. ¿Me repite su nombre y con qué organización está?
Rolando Rodríguez, soy vicepresidente de mantenimiento para el tránsito, para la sindicato de DART, so the Automated Transit Union.
Fantastic. Okay. Muchísimas gracias, Fernando.
Hasta ya.